In this Akai Pro tutorial, I'll show you how to set up MPC 2 or MPC Beats as a VST plugin that you can use in other DAWs. Since many of the plugins and virtual instruments that come bundled with MPC 2 or MPC Beats don't include VST installers, this is a great way to be able to use these plugins in other software. In this video, I'll be using MPC 2 as a VST in Ableton Live 11 Lite, but this process is virtually identical if you're using MPC Beats. Before getting started, here are some things you'll need. Of course, you'll need MPC 2 or MPC Beats installed and activated on your computer. You'll also need the VST version of MPC 2 or MPC Beats installed. If you've previously completed a full installation of MPC 2 or MPC Beats, you likely have the VST version installed already. This option is selected by default during installation. If you deselected this option while installing, you'll need to reinstall your software and make sure that the VST option is checked. You can double-check that the VST version is installed by checking your computer's VST folder. On macOS, the default VST file path is Library, Audio, Plugins, VST. And on Windows, it's C, Program Files, Steinberg, VSTPlugins. I've put these file paths down in the description so you can easily copy and paste them. Additionally, if you're using MPC hardware to control MPC 2, it needs to be in controller mode. Also make sure that your MPC hardware and software are running the same version number, and that you've installed your hardware's MPC controller mode driver on your computer. So, with that out of the way, let's dive in by creating an MPC MIDI track in our DAW. First, create a new MIDI track in your DAW. I already have a blank MIDI track ready, as you can see here. The VST version of MPC 2 or MPC Beats will appear in your DAW's plugin folder as MPC, MPC 2, MPC Beats, or MPC 64. Simply enable this VST on your MIDI track, then open this instance of the MPC plugin. In Live 11 Lite, it'll pop up automatically after loading. Now that our MPC MIDI track is set up, let's route our MIDI in. If you're using MPC 2 or MPC Beats without an external MIDI controller, or if you simply don't need specific MIDI channel routing, set the input channel setting in your MPC instance's track to all. If you do plan on using an external MIDI controller, you can use it to control specific tracks within your MPC instance. First, make sure your MIDI controller is configured to send MIDI data through your desired output. Next, in your MPC instance, select the track you want to control with your MIDI controller, and within its MIDI menu, set the input channel to match the output channel you've selected. Next, let's learn how to route audio out from individual tracks in our MPC instance into our DAW. So, as you can see here, I've created a little project in my MPC instance. It has three tracks, one for drums, one for bass, and one for keys. Quick side note, since MPC is loaded into your DAW as a VST plugin, your MPC project tempo is controlled by the DAW. Notice how when I change the project tempo in Live 11 Lite, the MPC project tempo changes accordingly. Anyways, back to audio routing. In your MPC instance, open the channel mixer. And in the mixer, you'll see a channel strip for each track in your project. On the track's channel strip, click the output drop-down menu, mouse over stereo output, and pick a stereo pair from the list to route the track's output to. Feel free to pick whichever stereo pair you want, except for out 1 and 2. This stereo pair is routed to the main output in MPC by default, and it won't appear as an available input channel in your DAW. So for my drum track, I'll pick out 3 and 4. For my bass track, out 5 and 6. And for my keys track, out 7 and 8. Be sure to remember which stereo pairs you choose, as you'll need to have that information handy for the next step. Speaking of, now that our audio out routing in MPC is done, let's create some bus tracks in our DAW that will receive the audio from each MPC track. Note that the specific locations of your track's routing settings will differ depending on which DAW you're using, but the general process outlined in this chapter will apply. In your DAW, create a new audio track for every track in your MPC project. Since my MPC project has three tracks, I'll make sure to have three blank audio tracks in Live 11 Lite. Now, configure each audio track so that it receives audio from MPC. You can usually do this in the track's settings or in the channel strip itself. In Live 11 Lite, this is done on the track's channel strip in the Input Type drop-down menu located under Audio From, so I'll make sure each track's input type is set to MPC. Next, we need to route each track's input channel to receive audio from the stereo pairs we selected earlier in MPC. In Live 11 Lite, open the Input Channel drop-down menu on one of the tracks, and you'll see all of the stereo pair outputs from MPC. This track here will be my drum track, so I'll pick output 3 and 4, since that's the stereo pair I routed my MPC drum track to. Do this with each of the tracks in your DAW to complete routing your MPC stereo outputs to them. Now, when I play something in my MPC instance, we can see that each individual track in my DAW is receiving audio from the MPC tracks I've routed them to. So, now we know how to route MPC tracks in our DAW, but did you know that you can also route individual pads from MPC drum programs? This enables you to have each individual sample from your drum program routed to its own channel in your DAW. Let me show you how. So, I've started a new project in Live 11 Lite and loaded an instance of the MPC VST, in which I've loaded a drum program and made a sequence. In your MPC instance, open the Pad Mixer, and you'll see that each individual pad in the drum program has its own channel. Just like when routing MPC tracks, you can route each of these pad channels to their own stereo outputs. I'll route the kick to out 3 and 4, the snare to out 5 and 6, and because I'd prefer to have both of these hi-hat sounds on the same track, I'll route them both to out 7 and 8. And finally, I'll route this white noise cymbal sound to out 9 and 10. Next, in your DAW, create a new audio track for each stereo output you just routed your pads to. I've routed them to 4 stereo outputs, so I'll create 4 new tracks. Just like when routing MPC tracks, I'll set each track's input type to MPC. Then, I'll set each track's input channel to match the stereo outputs I selected in MPC. Now, when I play my sequence in my MPC instance, we can see that the audio from each pad I've routed is being sent to an accompanying bus track in my DAW. As always, for more resources, tutorials, and technical support for MPC 2, MPC Beats, and Akai Pro products, visit akaipro.com/support. We also have lots of Akai Pro video tutorials available here on our channel. Check out the playlists linked in the description to watch more. Thank you so much for tuning in, and have fun implementing MPC 2 or MPC Beats as a VST in your music production endeavors.